Hi everyone, welcome on my channel. So today we're gonna start a little tutorial video about Luke and how to play the character. He's out for like 2 weeks now and I'm enjoying to play him a lot, honestly. He's really strong, he got a lot of tools, he's comfortable on every part of the screen. So to start, he looks like a kind of Shoto style. What I mean is he got a fireball, he got a kind of Tatsumaki or something who that you can use to corner carry your opponent and stuff. And of course, he got a DP. He also got a lot of health and stun, I think. Not a lot, but like a correct amount of health and stun, like 125 health for 150 stun. So that's quite correct. So we're gonna start with his strength and his weakness. So about his strength, his main strength is clearly the fact that he can convert into huge damage from any touch and put you in the corner really fast. That's clearly his main strength, I think. One of his second one is his mobility. Got a great mobility with a 17 frame dash forward. That's one of the best in the game. Backdash, 21 backdash. So that's the best backdash in the game. So clearly a character who can put himself where he wants on the screen really fast. His wall speed is pretty decent also. And from a whiff punish or anything like that, have great damage. Also, from his archetype, of course, he's a character who is really comfortable on any part of the screen. Far range, he got a great fireball. Max range, his fireball won't reach, but he can charge his V-skill install, so the opponent don't want to let him on this situation. So clearly a character who have a lot of strength, even if it's basic strength. So the character don't have a lot of weakness. One of his main weakness could be that he can struggle a little bit against zoning, fireball zoning, even if he got an armor move and all those kind of things. When he loses the fireball war, it can become complicated for him. Like for example, I think Rose, Sagat and those kind of characters can be annoying with the fireball game. One other weakness is that his 4 frame punish is not good at all. Like for example, dash straight, some heavy kick on block and stuff. His quickest normal is 3 frame, punching light punch, with a correct range. But he don't have a 4 frame punish who go far, like Stanley Kick of Sakura and those kind of characters. One other thing is that he got a good amount of recovery on normal moves. It's pretty easily wish finishable, of course, because those moves have a lot of reward, so that's totally normal. But that is his main weakness, so that's not a lot, trust me. So let's move on his main normals. Okay, so in terms of main normals, of course, the basic Crunching Light Punch. 3 frame, confirmable with a lot of things, a lot of special moves. DP, of course. A really good move. You can use it as a tick throw. So Crunching Light Punch on block plus 2 into throw in 5 frames, of course. Second move, we get Crunching Medium Kick. This move is like one of his main tools in neutral and in pressure to make the opponent scared to wall back, to whiff punish some things, etc. It's also confirmable on block. So for example, I will try to do it 1 or 2 times. 16 frames, so you need just a little bit of focus and should be okay. Also, we got standing heavy kick. This move looked a little bit like the Guile. You know, he's a fan of Guile, so it looked a little bit of knee bazooka. Like, if I record only block, plus 1 on block, good spacing. So, great move. Also, it's rare confirmable. You can lead to Crunching Light Punch on hit and on block to keep the pressure into combo. So that's a really good move. Also, we got Back Heavy. This move is really useful against projectile. You can crush counter projectile and start up with this. For example, I record a look with some fireball. You see, I can crush counter him really easily. It's also a good anti-air. You can use it and lead sometime to some combos, some cool combos. I really like this move. Also, we got Crunching Medium Punch. This is one of his main pressure move, like plus 2 on block, You cannot tick throw immediately behind, but if you walk a little bit, it's gonna be okay. Lead to back medium punch frame trap. So on block, you can use it. That's your main frame trap. This one. This is pretty basic one. Be careful because, like you see, -7 on block. Also, we got forward heavy punch. Forward heavy punch is a move that you can use to just check if it's safe. It's -2 on block. So just check what your opponent gonna do, backdash, press a button, if he don't do anything. And on it, you got a great reward. You got standing light kick, for example, from this range. And close range, you got back medium. So really good move. Also a crush counter move. Really too good damage. So that's really good. Also, so the standing heavy punch. Standing heavy punch is one of his main whiff punish tools too. This one got a good reward. Like, for example, you can get some good corner carry, some good damage, and some good situation just after that. So great tools, multiple style, multiple way to play. Of course, he got punching heavy punch with an anti-air, but we'll speak about that later. Let's move on, air normals. About the air normal, so you will use the jump heavy kick as the main jumping tool. Of course, it's not a cross-up. If you are on the cross-up angle, you will use the jump medium kick. This is a really great tool. Sometimes you can do some ambiguous setups, pretty hard to block. Also, the last hair normal, the main hair normal to air is pretty much the jump medium punch. Really good tool because it lets like the back heavy on juggle. So you can sometimes get a DP, sometimes you can get the flash knuckle level 2. Sometimes you can convert it by a lot of way. So a really good move. The second hair to air move will be the jump light punch. No, so this is pretty much the defensive jump back at the last moment, like for example against a Kamin V-Trigger or those kind of situation. Still a really good move, a correct move that you can use sometimes. So about the special moves, we got the Sandblaster. This is his projectile, pretty good projectile, honestly, really fast and work well in combos and stuff. If you want to have the range, you need to use the heavy. If you want to have a better frame data, you need to use the light one, like a little bit less startup and recover with the light one, etc. The EX one go almost full screen. And of course, to it, you get the knockdown, so that's a really good EX move. Now we have the Rising Rocket. This is his DP. So all the variation of his DPs are anti-air. So you will not lose to a jump, whatever the version of the DP that you use. But you want to use the DP corresponding to the situation. You want to use the heavy DP on jump out, and you want to use the light DP on some ambiguous jumps, you know. The EX DP, of course, is invincible for frame. A pretty good EX DP, 200 stun, etc. So after the DP, you are on +2 situation, the heavy DP, the medium DP, +4. And it depends also sometimes of about the situation when you anti-air your opponent. For example, an anti-air DP, if you dash after that, you will be more plus than a grounded DP, of course. Now the Avenger, this is his run motion, so quarticle forward kick. You can have multiple variation, three variations, so the empty variation, doing nothing, not really useful. The overhead variation, the kind of YOLO thing, you can use it sometime, but I don't recommend it to use it too much. The variation, the most important is the punch variation, because this provides you a okizem, so you will be able to mix your opponent on wake up and to do whatever you want, tick throw, mic T, etc. The EX version of this move is have a armor on the third frame. So like for example, if I record a crunching medium kick into something, you can sometime get your way in by the YOLO possibility. Be careful, all those variations are unsafe, of course, but this is something you have to know. Now we'll speak about the most important thing of look. This is the flash knuckle. So the flash knuckle is a move, quarticle back punch, who have a lot of variation. So first, the basic variation, you've got 4, of course, the light one. The light one who put the opponent on juggle, on the air. the medium one who have better range and good situation, and the heavy one who hit with a lot of range and get the knockdown, etc. The EX1 has only one variation. You will understand what I'm saying that just right after. So it's a move with minus 8 on block and lead to good combo on it. It's a really important move. So why I'm saying that the Flash Knuckle is one of his main tool and more important tool and one of his most deep tool? Because you can charge it. If you charge the Flash Knuckle, you will have different property. For example, the light one, you see the difference? 2 hits, more damage if I charge it. And the situation after that is also different. I can get the Flash Knuckle medium, for example, right after, or the DP, whatever I want. So this is really important to know and to be able to understand the timing and to practice to have the most optimized combo you can have. Of course, I will show you all the combo right after. So right now I will speak a little bit of the situation of the Flash Knuckle. So I showed you the light, the medium cause give you a wall bounce, so you will be able to have a conversion with a DP or whatever. And the heavy one give you a better knockdown, a bit more damage, and especially the heavy one is interesting on block. So let's see. Okay, the light one charge minus 8, the light minus 11, so you do not want to use it on block. The medium, same, you are unsafe, and until the medium level 2, you are safe on block, you are minus 2. So this is something that you can use sometime on block if you don't want to, like some like that, you can use it sometime. The heavy one is minus 2 on block, leave you on throw range, so this is not something that you want to use too much on the guard of your opponent, of course. And the heavy one level 2 is plus, we are finally plus, but we are not in throw range, so this is important to know. Now, I said that the Flash Knuckle have a lot of variation. It have another one. One more, with the V-skill. I will speak a little bit more of the V-skill right after, but there is the thing. When you have the V-skill on, you are immediately on Flash Knuckle level 2. So, for example, I show you the combo Crunching Light Flash Knuckle. Now, with the Flash Knuckle level 2, with the V-skill, I will be able to convert it with something else. And that shouldn't be possible. So one of the last thing about that is that you have a third level when you have the V skill, because you are immediately level 2, but you can keep it charging. So the situation that you can get with the Flash Knuckle level 3 is really different than the level 2 and level 1, of course, on block and on hit. Like for example, the Flash Knuckle level 3 lead to another level 2 if you want. Like this, and you can have huge damage. On block, let's try it. You are plus 3 on block from the medium, so that's really good. The light one becomes safe on block, minus 2. The heavy one become literally plus 4 and in throw range of your opponent. So having this V-skill is pretty important in the game of Luke. But whatever, I will speak more about that with the V-skill thing. The EX1 is unsafe, I said it, and yeah, let's move on. So what do we got to stop an opponent who try to jump on us? So the main basic thing, I already speak about that, is that the DP. The DP is really important, you can use it, the heavy DP on long jumps, the light DP on close jumps. You want to use the cross-cut DP on cross-up jumps, I let you watch again the manipulation that I done. I walk under the jump and I do the half circle back and the medium. It's really easy to do, but you need a little bit of practice. Another one for beginners, a little bit, I will say, crunch heavy is a good anti-air. I will prefer to see a player who do consistent anti-air than miss every time his DP and stuff. So of course it's not optimal, it's not really good, it will trade, etc. But if you are a beginner, I recommend you to do this, and when you are comfortable, use the DP. Also, of course, the jump medium punch will lead to conversion on some situation. The back heavy also lead to some conversion. Like for example, I can activate dash forward DPCA and all those kind of stuff. With the crush counter, you will have even more conversion possibility. So we got multiple anti-air possibility, But what I recommend the most of the time is the DP. Easy, you can stay crouched. If I want to go a bit on a high level, I recommend to DP crunch. So you stay crunch, down, diagonal forward, and medium. So that's all. That's the optimized DP, because you will be a bit more crunch on the ground and it will be easier for you to DP. There you go. So let's speak about the EV system. So first we got the suppressor. This is his V-skill 2. This V-skill is pretty interesting, I think, for a beginner, because it's a move who beat throw. So the character is based a lot of, I think, on shimmy and throw bait and all the stuff. So if you are unfamiliar with those things, I recommend you to use it. It's also a move with only minus 2 on block. So this is great. Good hitbox also. He walked back a little bit before hitting his opponent. And it's also special cancelable. So if you want to take it and stay plus on block, you can use it like that. So is this skill 1? I already spoke a little bit about it, but I recommend to not use it too close to your opponent, because it takes a lot of time, 50 frames to be on. But once you get it, you are in a really comfortable situation, because you don't have to confirm anymore your crunching medium kick. If you want, you can, like, for example, just use it like this, get you huge damage. And if your opponent blocked it, you are only minus 2 on block. If you understand what I said before about the flash knuckle, because the flash knuckle would be immediately level 2. So this is really good. Also, you can sometimes throw flash knuckle heavy, B plus on block, and try to steal a throw or something like that. So a really important V-skill, in my opinion, the main V-skill of the character, who open a lot of combo, a lot of possibility, a lot of frame trap, is confirmed, become crazy on it, on block, whatever the situation is, the character just become monstrosity. He got also a pretty good V-shift, I think. He walk back a lot, so this is really cool. His V-reversal is quite basic, 17 frame, forward, heavy forward and 3 kick, of course. Okay, we'll jump, but whatever. So a pretty basic V-reversal. I recommend to use V-reversal of V-shift a lot with the character, because you don't have a 3 bar V-trigger, you have only 2 bar V-trigger. We'll spoke about the V-trigger right after. And even if you use a bit of V-meter during the round, you will build it back and you will still have your V-trigger at the end of the round. So that's what we want. So about his V-trigger 1. His V-trigger 1 gives him another special move. A fireball projectile that you can use using the V-trigger input. That's really strong, because you can use it by multiple different ways. Like a combo extender. You can use it as a frame trap, for example. So I record a look, we will use crunching light punch after a move. So like, for example, my forward heavy punch is minus 2 on block. But if I use this, I can frame trap my opponent. I can also do it with the standing medium kick. So it opens a lot of mind game in situation where Luke is like minus. Also, it's only minus 2 on block. So that's really good, because you are safe. Also, this move can be upgraded using 1 meter. If you use the EX Fireball before, you will have a stylish version of this move. Also, more damage and a really, really good move. So yeah, a combo extender, frame trap possibility. Also, Luke have a really special thing in SF5, is that his V-trigger going up with time. So be careful with that, because if you get hit by anything, like for example, just the crunching light punch, whatever. You see, my V-trigger is going down. More I lose health, more my V-trigger is going down. And same in the reverse way. Like for example, crunching medium, back medium. You see, counter it, but my V-trigger is going up. If I do damage to my opponent, my V-trigger is going up. So it's really particular. It's really different from the other character in the game. But I can recommend this V-trigger to beginners. It's really easy to use. Really basic V-trigger, combo extender. If you just want to use it like this, you can use it like this. Your opponent gonna jump, you can DP him. So this is a really great V-trigger. So to speak a bit about the V3R2. The V3R2 gives you the opportunity to cancel a flash knuckle by another flash knuckle. So for example, if I use medium flash knuckle and I input the motion of the heavy flash knuckle during the medium flash knuckle, I will have this combo. So for example, I can have better damage with for a crunching medium kick into CA. Then if I was just doing crunching medium kick DPCA. Also, you can use it like frame trap tools. For example, we have we have a light punch there. So my light flash knuckle is minus 11, but I can use the medium flash knuckle we trade with this crunching light punch and have the trade combo to have a lot of damage and a good situation. This V trigger is really technical. You need to practice a lot to watch the situation and what you can do with this V-trigger, but it allows a lot of interesting stuff and a better situation every time you have a flash knuckle on block or on it. Okay, let's talk a bit about the CA. The CA come out in 5 frame. The motion is double quartical forward into punch. This super is really good because whatever the situation when you're gonna hit your opponent, you're gonna be in the same wake-up situation in terms of positional. You see where you stand up right here? It will always be, whatever the situation is, on this situation. Also, this is one of the most damaging super, 340. That's a lot, that's like Karin. And it leaves at plus 19, so if you dash right after your super, you are in a plus 2 situation. That's really good. You are not in a throw range situation, but you can impose a main game to your opponent, activate your V-trigger, etc. So a really great super that I recommend. If you want to cancel a special into this super, first you can cancel most of the special with Luke, except run overhead by the super. So DP, you can cancel flash knuckle, you can cancel run shoulder for too cheap sometimes. But I recommend the DPCA most of the time because it's the combo who deal the maximum damage in that situation. Alright, so about the combo, Luke got a lot of variety of combo, a lot of route and a lot of different way to use them, technical combo and easier combo. So we're gonna start by light combo, medium, heavy, corner combo, go back mid-screen and check what we have on crush counter and how to punish a DP. All this, no matter. Okay, crunching light punch, wake up with target combo. This is a basic combo, really important one because you will stay close to your opponent after a dash, even if he backroll. Another combo, crunching like you, crunching like punch DP. For this one, I only recommend to use it if you kill or if you stun your opponent, because after this combo, if you dash, you will be really far to your opponent and you will not be able to impose it something good. Another combo who can be useful sometime is crunching like you, crunching like punch, flash knuckle light punch, because the flash knuckle will hit like 99% of the time. It got a really great range, so it's important to know it, even if it does a bit less damage than target combo. About medium, we get crunching medium, back medium, flash knuckle light, level 2. It's important to work on the timing of the level 2 flash knuckle, because this combo is really important for Luke. And flash knuckle medium, you can dash and get your mix up. Same than before, if you don't want to get the mix up, if you kill or if you stun, you use the heavy DP. About heavies, so heavy combo, one of the most important combo of Luke is standing heavy, flash knuckle level 2 and run shoulder. This combo, you will need to practice it a lot because you will see it again and again and again in a lot of variation of Luke. So this is really important. You can do it with crunching heavy, of course. Same. The combo with crunching heavy is a bit easier than with standing heavy, but you need to practice both. Okay, so let's go in corner. Corner, no, so same then with the light combo, but you will use the heavy DP most of the time in this situation because you are close to your opponent, so you just want to get the damage. You don't care about dashing and mixing up your opponent. Okay, we got medium. Medium change a little bit. Light fireball and medium DP. You want to use the heaviest DP possible, of course, to have the maximum damage on your combo. So, punching medium, back medium punch, light flash knuckle level 1, level 2, then light fireball and medium DP. Okay. About heavies, it changed a little bit. Like we will do crunching heavy, flash knuckle level 2, medium fireball, medium DP. That's what you can do without any meter. So it's a good combo and you still have the mix-up possibility. So mid-screen, let's see how to punish a DP. So first, you need to understand that if you punish with a crush counter, you will do less damage than if you punish with a normal combo without the crush counter. Let's see. 2-8-3, okay, with the crush counter. Two-eight-six without the crush counter. So it's important to use crunching medium, crunching heavy. It's better than back heavy. Against Shoryuken, like Shoryu Reaper of Ken, or those kind of Shoryuken, the double Shoryuken, you can jump, neutral jump, and it's the same. Jump, crunching heavy, medium, and run shoulder. This is some great damage and some great situation. Okay. The crush counter move of Luke, he got multiple crush counters, sweep, back heavy, forward heavy. But we will focus on back heavy kick and forward heavy punch. So, the back heavy kick is really interesting and a great crush counter move. Why? Because it's really positive. It's positive at a point where you can even dash and get your combo. So at some distance, you will be even able to standing heavy punch and to get the damage. If you are on a range when you can get the standing heavy punch, use the standing heavy punch. But sometimes it will whiff. For example, this range maybe? Yeah, you see it whiff. So on this range, I need to dash forward and to do the combo that I showed you before. This is the combo you want to use. The other crush counter of Luke is the forward heavy punch. The forward heavy punch is a great move also because you get combo despite the situation, counter it or no. Same for the back heavy actually, but it will go forward, so you will have a lot of chance to get the combo. But on the crush counter, you are plus 10, so you can get the standing heavy punch. And flash knuckle level 2, run shoulder, the basic one. If you don't have any crush counter on those moves, you can get the standing light kick. And if you are really close, you can get the back medium punch. Same for the back medium. For the back heavy, excuse me. So this is two important moves. Also, of course, Luke got plenty of basic combo like crunching medium kick fireball and all those kind of combo. Of course, crunching medium punch fireball, etc. But that's for the basic no meter combo. So there is a last thing that I would like to include in terms of no meter combo. You can also do it with meter. But it's the possibility to set switch with your opponent with this. With the medium DP, if you delay it the maximum at the good timing, you will have an autocorrect DP and you will put back your opponent in the corner. You can also do it with the light DP. It's a bit technical. The light one is easier than the medium. But if you want to practice that and you want to optimize your look, I think this is something you need to be able to do. Okay, now let's see what we got with the V-skill meter only. Crunching light, light flash knuckle, medium flash knuckle. Crunching medium, back medium, light flash knuckle level 3, light flash knuckle level 2, medium flash knuckle. Standing heavy, medium flash knuckle level 3, medium flash knuckle level 2, run shoulder. This combo can be a bit tricky. If you want to do something else, you can do this one. Of course, the situation is not as great, but it's way easier to do, and if you struggle a little bit on this one, you can use it. So now in corner, light, light, flash knuckle level 2, light fireball, medium DP. Crunching medium, back medium, light flash knuckle level 3, light flash knuckle level 2, medium fireball, medium DP. You can also use the heavy DP, but it's on your risk because sometimes it's gonna whiff. So crunching heavy, medium flash knuckle level 3, light flash knuckle level 2, light fireball, medium DP. This is also a really important combo, and the same combo that mid-screen, so it's not really hard to do. So this is your main route without super meter with Luke. Of course, if you have like one opening with like that, you can do medium fireball, medium DP, and all those kind of stuff. But this is your basic way to convert with no meter. There is a last combo I want to show you. It's this one. A bit harder than the previous one that I showed you, who look like this, but is more optimized. Medium flash knuckle, medium DP. I show you with the fireball, but if you want, I recommend to practice this one. It's an important one also. 1 meter combo, Nové skill. Conching la kick, conching la punch, XDP. Why not? Sometime you have to finish the game. Punching medium kick into flash knuckle EX, flash knuckle medium punch, corner carry, etc. Same for the medium punch. Standing heavy, one of the most important combo of Luke, I think. So standing heavy, medium flash knuckle level 2, EX flash knuckle, run shoulder. You need to practice this combo, this is really important. Corner combos. Continuing medium kick, EX flash knuckle, medium flash knuckle juggle, medium DP. This combo need a bit of training. This is not a really easy one. If you want a easier one, there you go. Will not miss this one. Heavy fireball, heavy DP, and not medium flash knuckle, medium DP. Another one on medium. Medium punch only this one. Continuing medium punch, back medium punch, light flash knuckle level 2. EX fireball, heavy DP. On heavies. Crunching heavy or standing heavy. Medium flash knuckle level 2. EX flash knuckle. And heavy fireball, heavy DP. There you go. That's for your corner combos. Okay, 1 meter plus this skill. EX to get the knockdown. Really important combo. Crunching medium, back medium, flash knuckle level 3, flash knuckle level 2, EX flash knuckle, run shoulder. I will use the heavy DP there to have the knockdown because I don't need the run shoulder, would deal a bit less damage than the DP. But if I was like in corner, in left corner, for example. And for 1 meter. I will use there the run shoulder to get the corner carry, or I will do the reverse side DP. About the 2-bar combo without the skill, nothing will change that much because you will be able to use the EX version of every move just after your EX flash knuckle. So for example, dash forward EX DP if you want the damage, EX run shoulder if you want to push your opponent. Also, in corner it will change a little bit. There you go, that's for your 2-bar combo in corner. And after the heavies, there you go. If you open with crunching medium kick, then EXDP. That's your 2-bar combo without the skill. Okay, so let's start with the combo 2 meter, 1 the skill. Dash forward EXDP, or you can also EX front shoulder. This one is really important and really interesting. You can just do the heavy DP if you want, but I'm showing you with the EXDP. Dash forward EXDP, of course, you know. So your 2-bar, 1V skill corner. As you can see, we use the EX fireball heavy DP because it deals more damage than EXDP at the end. Heavy version. That's your max damage. So about the CA combo, you will use the heavy DP, most of the time the heavy, but not every time, as a way to link the CA to your combo. So I already showed you the combo that you need to use in the part combo no meter, with or without the V-skill. And you will just add heavy DP, CA, or sometimes you will have to do medium DP CA or light DP CA to the end of your combos. So about V-trigger 1, this V-trigger is not really much the combo V-trigger. You can use it as an extend tool like that, using the fireball into the trigger. And most of the time you will use it like that even in combo. Like for example, after the medium flash knuckle, heavy fireball, the trigger fireball. This is a good combo, but like you see, you didn't get the knockdown situation, a good knockdown situation where you are close to your opponent. So I don't recommend to use it a lot in combo, but more in neutral or in extend like this from a poke or something like this. In corner, it's gonna be really interesting because you can get a bit more damage and also you still are close to your opponent. So in corner, it's really good and really interesting to use it like that. Also, you can sometime use 1 meter to have extra damage. Of course, you don't have the Oki, but you get some great damage. So in terms of combo, this, in my opinion, this is the best V-trigger, but it's not the creative combo V-trigger. It's more the basic and well-round and tool in every situation V-trigger. So the V-trigger 2 is really deep. There is a lot of things to know and a lot of variation in terms of combo, but I will try to show you the most basic one and important one that you need to know. Some formal light opening, you get this. Good situation, good damage, not spending a lot of the jauge. You got the same variation from a crunching medium kick, almost. From crunching medium punch, it starts to be interesting because this is one of the best situations that Luke can get. A lot of corner carry, you didn't spend that much meter, and great damage. On heavies, big damage, corner carry immediately also, and the problem is that you spend a lot of V-jauge there, but you can have a variation with less V-jauge, like this. You see, a bit less damage, of course. So that's for your no meter, mid-screen, V-trigger 2, BNBs. Let's see what we get in corner. Light DP there. Heavy fireball. Medium DP. Quite the same. And on heavies, you can do this one if you want, but you have another one with a bit harder. There you go. Flash knuckle juggle into medium DP. You can practice both and do the one that you like the most and that you are the most comfortable to use in real match. Alright, we got the V skill and the V trigger. Let's see what he got. Run shoulder, you can get the DP if you want, of course. This is on crunching medium kick. Heavy DP. Heavy DP, of course. That's your mid-screen BNB from V-trigger and V-skill on. V-trigger to V-skill on. That's on the lights. On crunching medium kick, we got this one, light DP. On medium, we got this one. Heavy fireball, medium DP. This one is really cool. Medium DP at the end. So we back mid-screen. So what you want to understand is the EX Flash Knuckle is your best friend in terms of meter spend because it allows you to choose the situation after it. If you want, you can dash heavy DP. If you want, you can run shoulder. The problem is that you will not be able to get it every time. Like for example, on this situation, I will not be able to do it. So I have to EX DP if I want to get the meter. With light combo, same, you have to EX DP in the corner. I don't really recommend to use the EX DP if you not kill the opponent. I already talked about that, but I'm not gonna show you every route, every combo, or the video gonna last like 3 hours, but now you should be able to create your own combo and to do what you have to do. Of course, like I said, use the EX Flash Knuckle in corner, projectile EX into heavy DP, pretty much the same than combo with 2 meter or 1 meter. So I want to speak a little bit about activation V-trigger. So what I recommend most of the time is to activate with the target combo medium punch V-trigger. But the thing is, with this target combo, if you activate on the last hit, you will be 0 on block. You don't want to be on that situation. If you activate on the third hit, you are plus one. That's what you want. At least you are plus. That's good. So what I recommend you is to put random block and to target combo. If it's on block, you activate on the third hit, and if it's on hit, you will activate on the second hit. Why on the second and on the fourth? On the fourth, because you will have less damage scaling. So at the end, your combo gonna do more damage if you activate on the second. So now it's on block, so I do the third. Let's see. On block, I do the third and I activate. On block, I do the third, I activate. On block, I do the third, I activate. This is random, so on it, let's go. And now you have your combo. So you activate on the second. This is really important. Other activation that you have, it's target combo, light, medium, heavy. This is a good one. Plus three on block, so you can crunching medium punch safely. Almost, if your opponent don't DP or anything. You have the EX Fireball, this is a really good one because if you dash, you are plus 5, so you can throw your opponent, you can shimmy him, you can mitty, you can do whatever you want. Not mitty, but you can press him. So this is a great activation. Of course, it costs 1 meter, but this is important to know it. You have the sweep, a correct activation, will lead to some cool situation on Concussion Turf, for example, I can show you. Medium DP, run shoulder, and if he block, I'm plus, there I was plus one, but I'm plus three or plus two. Let's see. Yeah, plus three, and I can grab my opponent, you know. So there is a lot of things to know with Luke about activation. You need to use the activation of the situation. Most of the time, I recommend standing medium punch target combo. This is a great one. EX Fireball is also really great. You have Heavy Kick also. We lead to great damage. So you need to mix between multiple activation and depending of the situation. Like for example, after the CA, you will dash. If you want to activate and to block all the option of your opponent, dash forward, crunching light punch, target combo activation. See? And I'm plus three and I can mix my opponent, etc. So that's about the activation on block. Okay, so last thing I want to speak about is the friend trap. How do I block an opponent who try to press after a move on block? So I have multiple answers. So I record a dummy who press just after a move on block. So the basic friend trap is crunching medium punch, back medium punch. Lead you on plus 6 on counter it. So you'll be able to do another crunching medium punch, or you'll be able to standing light kick if you want to go safe, etc. Another great friend trap, back medium, same situation. You are plus. Another friend trap, crunching medium, crunching light, crunching medium. Get the conversion from that. You've got multiple ways to stop our opponent who try to press after his after the moves on block. But the thing I want to show you, the most important thing, is that you can frame trap after this move, the standing heavy punch. It's minus 5 on block, right? So you're not supposed to be able to frame trap, but you can. With the heavy flash knuckle, this will beat our opponent who try to press just after that. You will be minus 2 on block if you don't have the V skill, of course. But there is another one who is even better than that, is the medium flash knuckle. Like what you see right now is that I press and I hold the medium flash knuckle long enough to add a trade combo, a trade possibility. So I'll do it again. Now it's a bit too. All right, there you go. There you go. And you can have another standing heavy punch right after that. This is really good, and you need to practice that and to be able to do that, because you will make scared your opponent to press. And what I recommend, once you are comfortable with it, you put block random, and when you go for heavy punch on block, you do the frame trap thing. When it's on hit, you do the maximum damage combo. So now on block, on hit, there you go. On block, you see, and you do this again and again and again and again. And this is a situation when you can force your opponent to do nothing where he's in plus 5 situation. This is really strong. There is a lot of things that I can say about Luke more, but right now I think it's gonna be too much if I say it. But yeah, the character is really fun, really cool. If you have anything, just send me in some comment or anything. I will read everything. Let's move on. Okay, guys, enough of theory. Now we're gonna go in rank match. I will do a few match for you and explain you what I have in mind and how to play like basic matchup. I will try to have different character, different opponent. One Urien. All right, the trigger 2. I think Luke can deal with Urien. Okay, in my opinion, right now I didn't practice a lot with against this character, but I think it's gonna be right. Let's see. I will try to charge my V-skill the faster possible. Okay, you charge yours, I charge mine. Whoa, he took it like really weirdly. Okay, I take the throw there. Continue medium kick. Let's back. Let's we finish this. Did he take? No, not a big taker, looks like. Okay, heavy DP, of course, to get the damage. He didn't take, I can throw him. Oh, no, maybe no. I have to be careful to the activation. Yeah, okay. Okay, let's see. I try to charge my V-skill again. I think it's in my favor. His V-skill goes so fast. I missed the combo. Alright, heavy DP there. Let's take this. Okay, should be dead. EX Flash Knuckle, EX Fireball, heavy DP. You know the combo. Okay, for the first match. So the big mistake that he make, in my opinion, right now, is to let me charge my V-skill. And Luke with the V-skill can throw some heavy punch randomly, and if it hits, the opponent can lose a lot of health. So I need to maybe to play a bit more rago, a bit more aggressive like that exactly. Oh, I miss again. That's not a really good thing to do. Oh, he get hit. DP there, safe. Finish, EX, yeah, of course. I thought that he would do the EX Shire Tackle, but he did a normal one. Let's charge again my V-Skill. He understand now that it's not in his favor to charge the V-Skill, but okay. Okay, we can keep going. Oh, not a single time. My god. Okay, let's get this. I can jump on Urien there. Oh, I should jump medium kick. No finish on this. Nice. He will finish me. Oh, nice. Really good jump. You use the CA. Nope. Oh, I could DP that. This is dangerous, honestly. Oh. Okay, I get this. I will try to charge my CA. Aegis. Okay. Oh, I did DP, I should EX DP. But I wasn't sure of the move. That was the very beginning of the startup. Okay, let's play a bit more focus. Nice. Okay, let's check this. Back throw. That plus. Good, he didn't press. Okay, should be dead. And CA. Alright. That's the first match. Let's see what we get now. Okay, Balrog. Interesting. Let's see. Oh, in this matchup, I cannot charge really easily my V-skill. But I will try to jump on him. Don't be scared to jump on him when you are on cross-up range. This is a very good one. Oh, Problemix. All right. Let's see. This will be a good match. I know that he played a bit Balrog recently. That's a good choice. The character is really good. Okay, let's see. Let's finish this. Nice. Nice check. Maybe DP. Oh, I'm lucky on this one. That was really close. I don't want to charge my V-Skillen to get a EX dash punch. Okay. I will chip him. Just to be safe, Balrog V3 or 2 is really scary. V3 or 1, sorry. Even V3 or 2. Nice. Mm-hmm. I backdash there. Oh, what is this? I tried to DP. I don't know what happened. Okay, we can push him in the corner. I will DP there. I should be able to throw. Oh. Ah, that's a cheap incoming. If he activate there, he's dead. Yeah. Because he wasn't able to V-shift or V-reversal or anything. Okay, for the first match. I wonder what this matchup can be. Like if it's Luc favor, Balrog favor, or 5-5. Oh nice, I will be. I'll pay that. Nice, he can roll back. He roll back after his... Yeah. Oh, he delay, roll back, I don't know. Mm-hmm. Let's try to come back. Nice. Nice one. Let's try to play a bit more close. Can get the punish there, heavy DP. And the heavy kick, multi. Okay, last round. Got meter, I need to be careful. Oh, nice. Oh no, that was EXDP. I wanted to EXDP there. That's not really good. Because I'm not... Yeah, you have to take it. And the EVDP. Oof, that was close. Really, really close. The EXDP will let me in a better situation than the CA because I will have the opportunity to throw or not. Okay, that's it for the second match. We got our last match. Let's do it. Okay, we got our last match. Let's see. Who do we get? Karin. Okay. I wonder what is this matchup also. Maybe 5-5. Karin is really comfortable on the ground on normal exchange, normal moves. But Luke got a fireball, and the damage of Luke can be a problem for Karin. So let's see. I will try to charge my V-Skill the fastest possible. That's safe, I don't care. Nice, really good. I can jump there. Yeah, I'm out. DP there, of course. Mm-hmm. Yeah, the sweep pack for us to activate. Well, back throw, that wasn't the best thing to do, honestly. Oh my god. That's okay, I take the throw there. Of course, he will activate. I will reversal this. Okay. When something happens and you have a lot of health, just be fixed to the plan. Be safe, that's the best thing to do most of the time. Oh, I did EX Flash Knuckle. That happened a lot. Side switch. Yep, we got it. I tried to DP there. Nice. Okay, why not? Take the grab. I take my V-Skill. I get the knockdown. Ah, I get the knockdown again. Oh, he got lucky there. Can he kill? Yep, he can kill. Nice. Oh, I tried to crunching medium kick. On this situation, you should be able to do that and to punish the Rika. It's alright. Yeah, finish. Heavy DP. Oh my god, the damage. Nice block. It's alright now. Oh, it's not alright. I have two. No. Not three time. You win. Okay, maybe it will be the last match. Let's see. Beat by 30. That's good. So you can play Luke by a lot of ways. That's a good way. Like I can play like a Shoto if I want there because he don't have meter, so he'll spend a lot of fireball and build my meter. Should probably jump pretty soon. No. Go back mid screen. Fireball. Okay, I see the answer. Why not? But we will get crushed by this maybe. Nice. Oh, nice. All right. Okay, I can go back to mid screen. Throw. I try to finish the shift, whatever. I recommend to activate on the. I told you that on the. Now I'm literally one of the best characters in the game in terms of zoning. You see, I can just feint, projectile, throw, projectile, and DP when he jump. Last round maybe, let's see. I would like to charge my V-Skill if you let me do it. Oh, I don't want to. It's alright. I don't take this throw, not this time. Oh, really nice walk forward. Okay. And this is over. There is the CA at the end. Okay, so guys, I hope this tutorial, this guide helped you. Welcome on my channel, my English channel. Honestly, I wanted to do some English content until long time ago. Because I need to work on my English, and also there is some people who speak English who follow me, so I want to give you something. So please subscribe to the channel, it's a new one, so it's important for me, it would keep me motivated. And see you soon, take care, bye bye!